Hi, this is Freddie. I'm going to show you all how to use the cutting torch. I have another video showing how to do the regulators, but this is just the torch, so if you want to know that, first turn the oxygen on this knob all the way up. Just turn it all the way on, and then you just turn the acetylene on a little bit just to light it, and then you light it with the sparker, and there's all this black smoke's coming out, as you can see. Just turn the knob until you can just barely, the black smoke barely stops. You don't want it any more than that because that's just a waste. And then you adjust this knob up here. That's the oxygen. That's the knob that lets the oxygen out. And then you want to just turn it until that powder cone, you see that, gets shrunken down to that point. And then you want it so that when you push that lever, it's the same size as when you don't have the lever on. I have a different video that shows it up close if you want to see it. Hobby art welding cheap. How to use a torch. Okay, so after you preheat it, you want to hold the flame halfway off, and then when it gets molten, push the lever, and then drag it straight across in a nice, fluid, smooth motion. You don't want to go too fast. I'll show you what happens because it'll not work, and you don't want to go too slow because it'll make too much slack. You need to practice this part. And here's what you look for on the edge when you see how that molten puddle starts right there. You want to do it like right before that or right when it first happens. You can't see it here, but I'm waiting till I see a little tiny speck of molten. Then I push the oxygen and then just drag it straight across. I can't really tell you the speed to go. You can have to practice, but you'll get it after a little while. It's not really that hard. You want to just keep the fire right on the edge, and it's hard to explain, but you'll get it. It's just the basics. This is going to be me going too slow just so I can show you what happens if you go too slow. Man, it's not the end of the world. It just makes a lot of slag, but if you go too fast, it just won't cut. If you go too slow, it leaves a bunch of goop coming out the bottom, which you don't want, but, you know, like I said, it's really not that bad. So it just takes practice to get it where there's not all this gunk hanging off. It's better to go too slow than too fast, though, because if you go too fast, I'll show you what happens. It just stops cutting. What I was showing you earlier when I was hanging halfway off the edge, that was actually Tom's video. I just took that little part out that wasn't cutting. I was just showing him moltenness. And you just want to look for that. And when you go too slow, here's what happens. It has a bunch of that crap dingleberries hanging off. But a lot of it will just chip off, and you can grind it off, but you don't have to do that all the time. Here I'm going to show you what happens when you go too fast in a spot. So you hang it off halfway off the edge. You wait till you see a little bit of moltenness, or maybe before. Once you get the hang of it, you'll know when the right time to do it. Then you press down the oxygen, and it'll cut through. I think what's happening is the oxygen is actually burning metal, like it's using the metal as fuel and just blowing it right out, catching it on fire, literally burning the steel out. And when it's molten, it's ready to get ignited by the oxygen and blown out. I could be wrong, but either way, that's when it's ready to cut. See right there, I went too fast and it stopped cutting. So when you do that, you don't have to worry. Just hold it there again and wait for it to get molten and start over. It happens to everyone sometimes. And here's what you look for. I'm going to do piercing, like when you just want to make a hole in the middle of the metal. It takes longer, but you just hold. This is not cutting. This is just to show you what to look for. See that little dot of wetness right there? That's when you want to push the oxygen down. So here's me piercing a hole. I did a couple other ones, but I forgot to turn on the camera, so I just kind of wasted some gas. But you just heat it up. It takes a while to pierce thick metal. This is half inch metal, but you just hold it there, and then you wait till you see that little bit of liquid, and then you push down the oxygen. You can push it down a little bit before that once you know what to look for, but if you push it down too soon, it'll spray a bunch of metal all over your face. You don't want that. If you wait until it's molten, it'll just all go through and none of it will shoot up at you. And that's just the little things fall out like this. As far as shutting down your torch, some manufacturers suggest turning off the oxygen before the acetylene. Others suggest the reverse. Read all your instruction manuals, and I have other videos that show you the fire close-up.